Hi there, my crafty friends. This video is a bit longer than my normal videos. This is going to take you through the entire process of me decorating this junk journal. I filmed the entire process, which was roughly 5.5 to 6 hours, and not all in one go. I did it over a couple of days, and what I've done is I have combined all the videos together and have put them at 3x speed to get it just under an hour for you to be able to watch it. If you'd like to see a full flip through of this journal, I do have a video which I will link in the description below. I've created this journal using a digital kit. It's a kit by Nectus Creations called Cottage Lane Volume 3. I will also put the details of that below. I will also quickly add that Nectaria from Nectus Creations is doing an exclusive offer of 30% off her entire Etsy store to all the people that are watching this video. So I have a special link to the discount code. If you look in the description of this video below, you'll be able to go directly to the store, her Etsy store, and see all her beautiful kits, and the code will automatically apply. So that's 30% off. I've started by creating a little pocket, and I'm making the tags and the journaling cards for inside. This card is a piece from the digital kit, and what I do with all my tags or any kind of ephemera that comes in the kits, I glue them onto a cardstock. This is just to make them a little bit more sturdy. My kits are print on regular copy paper, which is 80 GSM on a laser printer. I use a glue stick for this part, but you could also use double-sided tape. The cardstock that I use to stick the tag, the ephemera, on, I use contrasting and matching colors that go with the kit. I also add generic tags and journaling cards when I am decorating the journals or filling the pockets, just plain ones that contrast well with the busyness of the designs. One of my favorite embellishments to make is a snippet strip. I love it because you can add all the different colors and elements that are throughout your journal, and they all connect into one. So I use little bits of paper and offcuts and embellishments that I've used through the journal. I just add them onto a strip of paper. The strip of paper is as long as the paper edge that I'm going to stick it to. And then once I've found all my little pieces, I run it through my sewing machine, just a plain running stitch down the middle, just so it all combines together. Now, if you don't have a sewing machine, you could just actually glue them down. Once I've done that, I let it overlap the page slightly on top and the bottom. That's a personal preference because I like things sticking out of my journal. I like it chunky with it sort of spilling over. And then I just attach the snippet strip with the hot glue. Something else that I like to add in my junk journals is art journaling elements. And I'm going to do that on this page. I'm going to add a series of layers, which include paint, cardstock, and then an embellishment on the top. I start with a burgundy, which matches the colors of the kit. I'm going to add some stamping with black ink and a script stamp. Next, I'm going to add some texture. And if you're not new to my channel, you know that I'm a bit of a texture junkie. I'm applying some texture paste with a palette knife through the stencil. This stencil I bought from the Reject Shop here in Australia. I'm applying some strips of paper, which will be the background of my embellishment. You'll notice that these papers are the same that I used in the snippet strip, and you'll see them throughout the journal. You don't need fancy embellishments, you can make your own. I just have a piece of paper that's from an old novel, and I'm going to cut out a heart. That'll be the main focal point of this page. When I put the heart against the background, I feel that it's a little bit lost. It doesn't really pop off the page. So to fix that, I'm going to add a little bit of a frame just around it. I glue it onto the cardstock and then I just cut around it with about a half a centimeter all the way around, so it'll be framed in that beautiful green. That will then allow it to pop off and show up as a focal point. I feel that the background still needs something, so I'm going to add some green splatter. Once I'm happy with all the placements, I will glue them down with the hot glue gun. I often get asked why I like to use my hot glue so much, and also if it makes the pages more chunky and difficult to write with on the other side. And the answer is I love using the hot glue because, as I've said before, it's an instant dry, and I like to sort of get things done. I don't like to wait for like craft glue to dry before I can go on to the next page. And there is some kind of buckling or thickness with the hot glue, but not enough that you can't still write or add anything else to the other side where the hot glue, well, it doesn't really go through the page. It might make it a little bit like wrinkly, but nothing that I think is too bad, and the pages still look good. When I decorate my journals, I don't have a premeditated plan of what I'm doing. I just put all the bits and bobs that I'm going to use, that I want to use in my journal, just around me. And as I go from page to page, I see what will suit it. So you'll notice during the video, there'll be pauses where I'm probably just thinking of what I'm going to do. I page back and forth through the journal, just seeing what I've done, because I also like to repeat some of the elements throughout the journey. Throughout the journal, which I find connects everything together. I don't personally, for my personal preference, like every page totally different. I like them to connect in some way. So I do repeat some elements throughout the journal and some certain techniques. Here I'm creating a journaling section, which is like a little flip book or flip notebook. I'm cutting little strips of paper. I've got them the same width but different lengths, so each one sticks out slightly more than the other one, so they're sort of like a waterfall. And then I'm just going to cut a few colors and stitch it together at the top with the sewing machine, and then just adhere it to the page with hot glue. This is a little envelope that comes with part of the kit. So I'm just going to cut it out and fold it and stick it. I'm not going to attach it with glue to the page. I'm just going to use it with a paper clip so that you can lift it off the page and maybe put a journal card inside or a little note, and it'll just be a little bit of interest on the page if it's attached with the paper clip. I feel the pages here need some color, but I don't want anything too chunky or too bold, so I'm going to do some stenciling. I'm just practicing the stenciling on a scrap piece of paper just to see that I have the consistency of the paint correct and that I get the look that I want. So I'm using the same stencil again, and I'm using some acrylic paint with a little sponge applicator, and I'm just going to gently dab it over the stencil, just some parts. I'm not going to fill the whole page, just to bring that pop of color. I think I'll just let the rest of the video run now. I won't do any more talking. I think most of it is self-explanatory from the actual video, but if you do have any questions, do feel free to comment below. I do see and read all your comments, every single one, and I thank you very much for taking the time to comment. Sometimes it is just to say that you like the project I've created, sometimes you have a question, and I do set time aside every week to go through my comments, to reply, and to answer questions where I can. So please be patient with me, I will get to all the comments. I really hope you enjoy this type of video, the style of it, and that it's an entire process of decorating a junk journal. I hope that it inspires you for your own projects. I'd love it if you subscribed to my channel and also click the little bell so that you're notified every time I upload new content. I have very many exciting projects for the next few months, and I really would love for you to see them and be inspired by them. I'd also like to let you know about the Full Deck Challenge that I have going at the moment. It's a challenge where you alter a full deck of playing cards. You can follow my tutorials or you can do your own. Please find us on Facebook. The group is called Full Deck Challenge Group. And then within the group, you'll see the link to the playlist for all the tutorials so far. I'll also link it below so it's easy to find. So now go grab yourself a cuppa or a glass of wine or whatever you like to drink, pop on some music or listen to a podcast, and enjoy watching the rest of the video. I will see you again soon. Bye.